Hey you guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back, I'm not going anywhere. Boost! I'm YouTube famous now, available in 2020, the album, Dad AF. Rock on, Gold Dust Woman. How are you guys doing today? It's my birthday weekend. I said that yesterday, but I'm gonna say it again. I'm gonna say it every day until my birthday. My birthday is on Monday. And I'm gonna be 48 years young. I'm gonna be 48 years old on a Monday. I can hardly believe it. I came out 30 years ago on Monday. It seems crazy. Okay, let's talk. So yesterday, Shane Dawson came out with a video called Taking Accountability. And I have received tons and tons of messages from people asking me what I thought about this video. And last night, I just kind of really wanted to think about what I wanted to say on this video. I've watched the video twice now. I watched it yesterday when he posted it, like right away. And then I literally just watched it about 15 minutes ago. I have some notes about some things that aren't necessarily just about Shane, but are about how we have accepted and approached past apologies and what we do with that and all that. I wanna say before getting into this video that this video is in no way attempting to change your mind. This is just simply me telling you my response to this apology video and what I'm choosing to do with it going forward. I mentioned this in a video the other day, and there's some different pieces to this on for me moving forward and whatever. And I'll get to that in just a second. A major piece for me, but I'll talk about that in just a second. I mentioned the other day a quote by Oprah that I love in talking about forgiveness. And when we talk about apologies, you know, when you apologize to somebody, it's, you know, basically like then they're gonna forgive you or they're not gonna forgive you. And Shane says in his video, like, you know, I don't know if you guys can forgive me, if you'll accept my apology or whatever. And Oprah in her quote, this aha moment that she had, says that forgiveness is accepting that the past happened, okay? Not that what happened was okay, but that it happened, and now what are you going to do about it? So the question I've been asking myself for the last 24 hours is, as somebody that had for a very long time supported Shane, what do I do now? What do I do now with everything that happened and his coming out in a video and taking accountability? You know, it would be really easy for me to get on here and pick apart this accountability video, of which I have to tell you I felt was very, very vague, and that there were a lot of things he did not address. It was very interesting to me that he didn't say Jeffree Star's name in the video, that he said he associates himself with people, but he didn't say Jeffree Star's name when a lot of this is about, let's just be for real, their friendship, that, you know, that's what has brought a lot of attention to this. So that was interesting to me. But, you know, like, I could go piece by piece and tell you guys things I thought about the video. I'm not going to do that. I'll probably talk about a few things as I go. I have to say, like, I'm not going to get on here and say it's a little too late, or that I thought it was a crap apology or a crap. I don't even know what it was. Like, I don't even really consider it an apology video. It was, yet again, somebody saying, I'm not this person today. But just take my word on it. And, you know, okay, fine. It is what it is, right? But I don't know, accountability for me is taking a look at who you were, and I've had to do this while I've been on YouTube, to take a look at who you were at that time, why you thought it was okay, not just excusing it away and saying that, oh, that was disgusting, or I don't know who I was, or I was doing it for shock value, but really taking a look at who you were at that time and saying, you know, like, this is it. Like, for example, okay, there's been a lot of discussion about the Shane Dawson doing blackface. I'm 48 years old. I don't believe that ever in my life did I think that that was funny, or did I think that that was, I mean, I knew from a very young age that that was not okay. So I don't know, that's a specific piece for me to look back on and say, like, oh, that, like, I was doing that for shock value, or I thought that was funny. I mean, okay, like, your videos weren't being made in 1980 or 1990. We were talking about past 2000, right? So past 2000, people thought that was okay. I don't remember people thinking that that was okay then. I don't know. And maybe what it really is that Shane's channel and his content has changed over time, and that all of his content back then was like very shock value, and now he's being seen as somebody that has been, you know, accepted and crowned the golden boy of YouTube. You know, one of the things that he has had an issue with over time is that he never got the praise he felt he deserved on YouTube. He has said that to me, you know, when I came for him in the TanaCon video, and I was very critical then of the video. You know, he said something to me of that effect. He reached out and was like hurt that I criticized the video. And he was like, I've never once, you know, now I'm getting it, and like you have to continue to say something about it. And it's like, okay, well, maybe nobody, maybe you weren't getting the praise you thought you deserved because of all this. I mean, I don't know. Like, I didn't watch this content of Shane Dawson, so I don't know. I will say it's not my apology to accept. I want to make that very, very clear. But, you know, when I hear all this and I hear a statement come out like that, I have to make a decision on what I'm going to do. Now, looking back at, and I'm going to read some comments and some tweets and things like that that I've received in the last 24 hours. But, you know, like, it's interesting for me sitting back and watching the YouTube world, you know, and talking about, like, you know, what happened with Laura and Manny, and what's happened with, you know, like, Jaclyn Hill, what's happened with other people. It's like, we want to decipher and dissect their apologies, you know. Last night, I wanted to rewatch Laura Lee's apology video, which it is not a great apology video, okay? It will go down in infamy as being the worst apology video I've ever seen, right? But, you know, it was interesting when I was watching it, because underneath there were tons and tons and tons of clips of, like, that people had pieced together of, like, people responding to it, reaction videos. And it was like this joke, right? Like, they would take clips of Shane Dawson's other videos and kind of, like, weave in these pieces of Laura Lee's videos. And what that said at the time was that people looked at Shane as this kind of, like, I mean, it wasn't him really reacting to it. Although there is a video of Jeffree Star, and I will link it below. It's like the Shane part is a joke. The Gabriel part, the Trisha part, and the Jeffree part are all real, and how they responded to Laura Lee and Manny. But, you know, like, it's interesting to me because at the beginning of it, like, there's all these clips of Jeffree. I mean, Jeffree Star literally came out and said, in regards to their apologies and them not taking accountability, he said, can you imagine? And he said, I'm going to get Can't Relate tattooed. But now Jeffree Star's sitting at home and he's not taking any accountability whatsoever. He's not coming out and defending his friend. He's not doing anything. So that was, for me, okay, like craziness. But that everybody viewed Shane Dawson as this person that could do no wrong, right? I'm not somebody that, and he says this in his video, that, you know, like, he believes that he believed for a very long time that if you make an apology, somebody should accept it right away. I feel like that's a really entitled state, you know? And he also says something to the effect of, you know, I felt like at that time that I could say anything and get away with it. That's another sense of entitlement. I mean, there's a lot of key moments for me here where I was kind of like, this is really how you've perceived yourself for years, is that you were way up here, that you were better than, that you were entitled. And that's not just about all of these statements. So, you know, like, I don't know, like, there were a lot of things that he said in the video that I wanted to believe, and then there were issues that I was like, I don't know. I want to go in here and I want to tell you what some of the comments are on the videos, because I was quite surprised. I had received some messages from people saying that he was deleting comments. I don't know if that's true. It can't be true, because when I went over here and I pulled up the comments, somebody said, how long, and I'm just reading them straight down, you guys. How long till Jeffree makes one of these two? Someone said, I'm sorry, but having anxiety is no excuse for being racist. Someone said, use me as Jeffree is the one that needs a piece of humble pie in the size of the Empire State Building button. Someone said, a lot of us have childhood trauma but aren't saying racist things or trying to justify. Someone else said, Jeffree hiding in his mansion. Someone else said, who else wonders what will happen to Jeffree and Shane's friendship? Someone said, I'm so happy these comments aren't just Shane, Stan saying, it's okay, we love you. Someone said, I mean, these are straight down, you guys, okay? Someone said, Twitter versus the comments versus the like to dislike ratio. I can't be the only one who finds that suspect. Someone, because he says in the video that he was inspired by Jenna Marbles, which to me makes me wonder, like, if Jenna Marbles had not made her video, would you not have come out and made your video? He also goes in there and talks about how his eyes have been open since all the things that have been happening recently, and I'm assuming that he's, like, referring to the Black Lives Matter movement. Well, if you knew that then, I mean, we're like a month out from that, like when it started, or a month and a half, 2 months. If you were having those thoughts then, why didn't you get on and make that video on your Shane Glosson channel and say, wow, like my eyes have been woken to who I was in the past and things like that, you know? And for those of you that want to come over here and say, why don't you do that? I did do that video. So I did talk about that in a video. So someone says, this apology is nothing like Jenna. She has grown as a person who has sincerity behind her words. It took Shane complaining about the backlash and leaving the internet for being a sensitive person to get to his apology. Someone said, Shane talking about the past, viewers, it's okay, just don't delete conspiracy theory videos. Someone said, drink every time he says that person, you will not leave sober. Someone said, y'all remember when Shane used to be considered as one of the big YouTubers with little to no drama scandals? Yeah, 2020 said new, okay. Someone said, well, I sure do hope all the people in the comments criticizing Shane aren't the same ones who buy Jeffree Star makeup line or watch his videos. Someone said, well, you can change your opinion. A lot's come out in the last 48 hours. I've had that conversation with people. You know, you can change your opinion like that. Mike and Jitty, Tawny and I, we were talking about that one night. We were driving around and, you know, I said, like, if I say something in a video, people will come and say, well, 2 days ago you said this. And she goes, I'm a human being. I can change my opinion like that. If I want to change my mind, I have the right to change my mind at any time that I want to change my mind. So the comments on the video are not great. I then went into Twitter last night, hold on a second, and I asked somebody, I asked people, hold on just a second, dun, 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 dun. I asked somebody, or I asked Twitter what they thought of this video. Where is my comment? One second, I can't get to it. I said, thoughts on Shane's new video, might read in my video. So I'm going to read a couple of these. Someone said, I'm going to need, this was Bunny, to see more than an apology. I need actions. You aren't sorry if you don't prove it. Someone said, I'm torn. Part of me wants to believe he's genuine, but my gut tells me it's BS. Someone said, always go with your gut. Someone said, where I'm from, when someone apologizes, we forgive them. Then watch their actions to see if they really meant it. I mean, they're pretty down the road middle. There's people that agree with him. There's people that don't. There's people right in the middle. Someone said, here's one. Shane Dawson, many of us have awful childhoods and do not act the way you did. You were still selling offensive merch before the hookup with Jeffree, so don't try to say this was all years ago, which is true. And I've gotten that comment for years that these videos, criticized for, he had merch on his merch shop for that before he went with a new merch shop. I mean, he didn't take that down until the series. So, he got to the Twitter note part, said it was a joke. A minute later, he says the note had so much anger in it and apologized. I thought that was interesting too. You know, it was interesting to me that he apologized to James Charles, which I think is fine. I think it's great, you know? And I, like I said, I asked him to take accountability and he took accountability. And so I think that's what a lot of people wanted him to do. I'm not gonna criticize the man for taking accountability. I don't know that he took a real look at himself, you know? But I do think in the note part of it, it was interesting that he apologized to James. He talked about the humble pie part. It was almost kind of like he went through Twitter and he read what everybody's big issues were and he just addressed each one of those big issues. But for me, it's like you came out and you called the beauty community toxic, which he doesn't address. He said he was never part of the beauty community, but he doesn't talk about the part where he said everybody in the beauty community was toxic. And then he comes out and he calls them vile, two-faced, whatever, bad. I don't know all the words he used the other day, but he didn't say anything about that. You know, he didn't say anything about Tati glamming up and coming for James. So he obviously still stands behind some of those points, you know. I don't know how in one second you say I was joking and the next second you say I was angry. Like, that doesn't fit together for me. I'm just, you know, my two cents about that. Someone said, do not for one second believe that note was intended to be funny. Someone said, I don't think it was good enough apology, especially to James. Just the fact that his tweet said no one deserves it to that extent tells me he knew and had a bit more involvement, at least knowledge, prior to Tati video. One of the things that's interesting to me in addressing the note is that he said that he had this, he talks about the restock and he said that like we kept on pushing it back and pushing it back and pushing it back. Well, that's interesting to me because the cremated palette came back. So why were you pushing the restock back? I thought it wasn't available. That's what I thought. So is that a lie or was that true? Like, I don't know. But he said he keeps on pushing the merch back. But then he said he sat down. This part was very like, I didn't understand when he was talking about like, he came out and he sat down and he wrote the note, but he had to put the merch stock out. But that he had been seeing all this stuff going on. Why didn't you put the note out then the restock? Like, why did you wait till the merch restock And then you put the note out. Like, that's always been interesting to me. Someone said, I think my opinion doesn't matter, as a white man, but I think this should have happened a long time ago, which he said, and I think the way he handled himself was the right way. No sobbing, no gray hoodie, no poor me. Heard and understood doesn't mean forgiven, though. Someone said, Captain of the edit, can he go more than a sentence without having to make an edit? There were a lot of jump cuts in this video. There were. Someone said... this is Liam McAvoy. Let's see what he has to say. Honestly, I have empathy and I like giving people second chances, but when you make jokes about certain topics, my brain tells me you don't deserve empathy. Empathy is understanding someone else, and I simply don't understand why you think it's okay. Someone said, ooh, you know there's a lot of opinions when the replies outnumber the likes. The fact he never addressed Jeffrey by name speaks volumes. Sure, he apologized again for bad jokes in the past and says that he regrets things more than anything in the world, but yet can't even acknowledge anything more. He holds his friends to a lower standard, WTF, and he said that he holds his friends and family to a lower standard than he would hold everybody else. You know, interestingly enough, I have to say, like, in with that comment, I feel like I kind of hold my friends and family, and I think they hold me to a higher standard than everybody else, you know? When I look at the world and I look at things out there that I don't understand or that are crazy or confusing to me, it's almost like I'm distanced from that or detached. But with my close friends and family, it's like I do kind of hold them to a higher standard. Like, you know, and he said in there, and this is the part that I want to talk about. He said in there that he addresses things off camera. Now, I have said this in several videos, and I'm going to say it again, that Gabby Hanna told me on a phone call that after Shane Dawson met with Jeffree Star for the first time, before his first series, that he texted her and told her that Jeffree Star still uses the language that he's accused of, and that to some degree he tried to get Shane to say it. I don't know what that's for, okay? Like, whether that, I don't know. I've heard a lot in the background from different people that Jeffree Star likes to record conversations. I don't know if that's true, okay? Possibly, I don't know what that would be used for. You do your own math, okay? I have said that in countless videos. Jeffree hasn't addressed it, Shane hasn't addressed it, and Gabby Hanna hasn't addressed it, but Gabby Hanna has unfollowed me. So last night, because I wanted to know this, okay, going into this video, I reached out to Gabby in a direct message, and I sent a very nice message, and I said, hey, listen, I'm sure you probably know, I've mentioned this in videos, I want to know for me, because I think it's fair to my audience, if Shane really said that to you, okay? Either he said it, and you have the evidence, or I don't know how I said it in the DM, but I said, or either he didn't say it and you just told me that. What is it, right? She didn't respond for 12 hours. She's been tweeting out, so I sent a question mark. I don't think that she has responded to me as of yet. I will see. Nope, she still has not responded to me, and I sent the original message late last night. So I still haven't gotten a response from her. Now, let me tell you why this is so important to me, okay? Because I know people are like, Gabby Hanna's a liar, Gabby Hanna this. Maybe she is, but the fact that no one wants to address this is a huge issue to me, okay? And I'll tell you why. Because if Gabby Hanna has information that Shane Dawson texted her that, and if it is true, then that means that Shane Dawson, number one, has not changed. But number two, we're not talking about addressing things behind the scenes. We're talking about the fact that Jeffree Star really has not changed as a person after all of these things that people are accusing him for with using this language and being this person. And Shane knew that and went in to go make those two videos. Not only that, but allowed a platform to give excuses for why he did that in the past. Shane allowed that knowing that he had not changed. And if that is true, that speaks to Shane and it speaks to Jeffree. And I want to know if that ever happened. I want to know why Gabby isn't addressing it and didn't say anything. She wants to come for every person else out there, but she doesn't want to address this. I think this is a serious issue when we are talking now about withholding support financially, viewership, whatever. Because if that's not the case and she made that up, then okay, whatever, she's a liar. But if it is true, and Shane really did say that, then he has protected Jeffree and he has painted a different picture of who he really is as a person. And if that's the case, then that's pretty dark to me, right? That you knew this, you went in and you sainted him and got everybody that now is like, oh no, because Jeffree Star gained a lot off of those series that he did with Shane Dawson. Number one, he gained a better reputation. Because before that, that wasn't the case, okay? And if Shane did that, then no, Shane hasn't changed as a person. And I want to know the truth. So, and I will tell you, that's not the only time that I have heard from other people, and I can't remember who, but I know I've heard it from other people, that Jeffree Star tries to get people to say certain things. So anyway, The next thing I want to talk about, and this is kind of off the subject, but this is about the apology. I'll tell you how I feel about the apology. Well, first of all, I'll tell you how I feel about it. Okay. After reading the comments and, you know, all this kind of stuff and just kind of watching it and taking it in myself, when we go back and we talk about Laura and Manny or we talk about anybody else, right? Like, I have invested a lot of time, energy, and money in supporting these people, okay? And, I am not somebody today, I used to be in my life, that when somebody would make apology to me, I'd be like, oh, that's okay, don't worry about it. That's okay, just don't worry about it, right? And, you know, like, I've said this in videos before, that my dad used to say to me when I was growing up, like, when I, you know, back in my, like, drinking days and, you know, drugging days back then before I got sober, I would say, I'm sorry. And he would say, don't say you're sorry, because sorry just means forget what I just did. And I don't want to hear that, because it's not taking accountability, you aren't making any changes, and I'm not seeing a different side of you. That's why today I'm not big on that word, I'm sorry. I'm bigger on, let me show you how I'm going to change. Let me tell you what I'm going to do, and then come back 6 months to a year, right? When all this went down with Laura and Manny, I did not watch them for a while. I didn't support them. And then I came back and I started watching them and I saw them change. I saw them stay out of drama. I saw them not stir up stuff. They're still not really in any kind of drama. Every once in a while, something, you know, like in a tweet or whatever. And I've seen a lot of growth and I've seen a lot of change. I've seen a lot of growth in James Charles in the last year. I don't know what's gonna come out. I mean, maybe more will come out and my opinion will change. But, you know, like, at this time, that's how I feel. And so I feel okay after a year of supporting these people, 6 months or a year, you know. But at this point, given what I have seen, I have to withdraw support right now of Shane Dawson. It's my time to give that time and energy to other more deserving YouTubers out there that I haven't given time and energy to as a viewer and as a fan. It's time for me to find some new people that are non-problematic to watch in my personal time and bring some light into my life. I don't want to continue to put money in people's pockets and support people with my views and my subscriptions and all that kind of stuff. That I just think, like, aren't changing or aren't learning. And that's where I'm at today. You know, I'm somebody that believes in change. I hope for change for all people out there, for you, for me, for all of us. I'm a believer that every single day that I get up, I hope to be a better human being than I was yesterday. And that, you know, if I fall on my face, I have to get back up and take a look at these mistakes I've made in my life, who I was, who I am now, and who do I want to be going forward. I've done much inventory and evaluation in my life. I wish that upon Shane Dawson. I wish that upon Jeffree Star. I hope that they go through amazing growth and change, because then you are experiencing true living, and that's what I hope for them. I don't want them canceled. You know, I want them to learn and to grow. I want that for every person out there, whether they're a YouTuber or not, right? But just one 20-minute video ain't gonna do it for me. It just isn't. Like, I'm gonna have to watch over time. And the reality is, Shane's not really posting anything anyway, so I don't know how we're gonna witness that change. But for me, I'm gonna have to witness change over time before I can go back and support that again. And I hope one day I can, you know? I hope one day I can sit back down here and be like, he really has changed as a person. Like, I've seen him do this, and I've seen him do that, and I've seen him take accountability, and he's changed, right? Like, but today, I'm not there. Now, I want to talk about this holding people accountable, because I went back and I watched some things last night in regards to the Laura Lee video and the things that had happened last night, because I wanted to get on here and I wanted to say something. So I do have some notes, so bear with me. It was interesting because I saw this clip that I was talking about earlier where it was talking about, it was Jeffree and Shane and Trisha and Gabriel responding to Laura Lee's apology. It was one video, I'll link it below. But I will tell you, really the only interesting part is Jeffree Star at the beginning and how he talks about all of that and how he perpetuated it. And I want to say this as well, that when people want to say that, you know, drama channels or other people are gleeful or getting excited about this, okay, whatever, you know, like, Jeffree Star was somebody that was very, very excited about the downfall of somebody at that time. So, you know, like, let's take a look at that. Let's take a look at the fact that he's not coming out and saying anything at this point. Like, it's very, very telling of who he, his silence speaks volumes to me. I'll just say that, okay? But I want to say this, that when I was watching this, the Shane part is a joke. So, like, it's not, like, he's not really reacting to Laura Lee. I just want to make that clear. But when I went in there, I saw the Trisha part at the end, and I was like, oh, that's right. Trisha made a video about Laura Lee. And so I went and I looked it up. It's still up on her channel. And it currently has 5 million views, which is a lot of views for Trisha Paytas. It has 301,000 likes and 6,000 dislikes. That's a lot of likes for Trisha Paytas. And the video is called, Laura Lee's BS apology. It's an 18-minute video of where Trisha Paytas absolutely 100% goes into Laura Lee, on Laura Lee. Now, Trisha Paytas, the last couple days, has chosen not to come out and address this. She is going full throttle for David Dobrik and the Vlog Squad, okay? Which, yes, I think that's a very serious issue. I don't know if I'm going to address it over here, but yes, I think it's a very serious issue. Do I think that the timing is suspect when all this stuff is going on with Shane, and she hasn't said one thing about Shane, hasn't supported Shane, hasn't come out and said anything when he's her best friend and we know that, and yet she's throwing all this stuff up? Yeah, it's deflection. It's complete 100% deflection. And, I watched this video last night, and it was interesting because I had forgotten this video. She says some very poignant things in this video. One of the things she says is that if you come out with racist statements, she says in there that she grew up at the same time as Laura Lee. She's the same age as Laura Lee. She grew up in a small town in Illinois, and yet she knew never to use that language. And she said, that would hold true to Shane Dawson too, right? Because they're about the same age. She says in there, the only apology that you should make, or the only thing that you should say if you've come out that with racist statements is, I'm disgusting and I was brought up by disgusting people. That's regarding racism, okay? And she says, and if you can't say that, then no one should forgive you. So I'm kind of wondering at this point, like, Trisha, are you going to keep the same energy? Is everybody going to keep the same energy that they've held other people to? Or because people love Shane and they've knighted him and he's the prince, are they just going to forgive everything? Like, that's the thing. And this is where we hold people to different standards. You know, she goes on here. I mean, I wrote a lot down of what she said. She said, even if she went back now, it's too late. She says that in there. You know, she said, that's for my second part of the video, but I went in here and, she says all of these different things. If you watch it, it's 18 minutes. And she says in there, like, she doesn't know Laura Lee. She's not in the beauty community, so she's inserting herself in the middle of it. She also references talking to Jeffree Star at the same time, which I think is really, really interesting, you know, that, like, she's talking to Jeffree Star, who's, like, got all of this out now, but he's not coming out and saying, like, I'm disgusting, I was raised by disgusting people. Shane Dawson's not coming out and saying that, but that's okay, okay? So, anyway, she goes on and on and on, and, it's just really interesting to me that they, she doesn't want to hold them the same accountable. All these people that wanted to hold Laura Lee and Manny and all these other people to this accountability, this level, give them a pass here, give them a pass there, give them a pass there. Well, I'm not saying, and I said, I don't want Shane canceled. I don't want anybody canceled. I don't even know what that means. I don't even know if I understand what that means, okay, today. Everybody that's ever been canceled is still around, so let's just, be for real on that. What I want is people to change and people to grow. I think that we need to hold these people to the same standard as we hold other people to, Some of these people lost careers. They lost years of their career, And we want to watch a video and say, it's okay, you're fine, it's okay, thank you so much. Like, I really believe it. For me, I don't know. I'll have to see what he does moving forward. Like I said in my other two videos, to me, it's not about the talk, it's about the walk, and I want to see the walk. I want to see what he does. I want to see who he is as a person moving forward. And I want to know, if what he said to Gabby Hanna was true. I want to know if that's a lie, or I want to know if it's true. And I can't believe that nobody will come out and talk about that to me, It's like, have you ever asked somebody a question, and when you ask them a question, they don't respond to you, and you're like, oh, because that must be the truth, right? Well, Gabby, Shane, and Jeffree, nobody's coming out and saying anything about that. It's just crickets over there, total silence, which makes me think that it has to be true. And if that's true, then no, I can't support somebody that would do that. I can't support somebody that would paint a facade of somebody that still uses language, still thinks that way, in 2018, 2019, and 2020, cover all that up to make two series, to sell a palette, to make millions and millions of dollars. If that's the case, no, he hasn't changed. And that needs to come out. I think that's very, very serious. So anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I love you, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.